Okay, we're starting our first advanced study, and apparently I'm supposed to go do this after making sure I installed the the add-on thing. Supposed to name it static 1, but I may have already did this before because it came up as static 2. Anyway, that these different types of studies we can do. So if this gives you a clue. Check mark on that, noting that we've assigned the material with alloy steel. Okay, now I'm supposed to click this. Alright, and I could have done it over here too on fixtures. Geometry is what I'm supposed to do. Okay, and this is very similar to what we had in the other program. So click those two inside faces. Pressure. So, we have force, torque, external loads of visor, gravity, centrifugal force, bearing load, remote loads, distributed mass, temperature, flow effects, and thermal effects. So, we're going to go with pressure. Selected face. And for that face, apply it that way. PSI in the units. Type 1000. Pressure value. So you should set the units first and then type later, otherwise it'll do a conversion. And then select OK. Pressure applied there. There's our fixture. Okay, or I could have, you know, come to the run and put its, hit the down arrow, would have done the same thing, so it's under run. Okay, so these are the settings that are supposed to be in here. It said something about it being for all tutors unless noted otherwise, so I don't know. But it's supposed to be standard mesh. It's supposed to be in millimeters or not, but they said these two, the global size and tolerance, are calculated by the program, apparently. They said automatic transition is supposed to be cleared. Jacobian points, 4 points. Draft quality mesh is cleared. Automatic trials for solid is set, and this wasn't set by default. Number of trials, 3. So, then I click OK, and that meshes our object. Now, we can click Run, and there will be a results folder up here when I do. See what the displacement was, so you can see how it's deformed. Yeah, but it's still using von Mises stress here. Details of a mesh that they wanted me to select for some apparent reason. Line up the displacement plot, and you can see, you know, where maximum displacement's occurring, and apparently what it is. It's in millimeters. About 1.6 millimeters, in fact, I guess, yeah. That other tag. Safety plot. So, the criteria formula from, you know, the previous express studies. Could even set an upper limit to it. The yield strength is what we should select. We've got that selected. Factor of safety distribution is what we're looking for, and click OK. Why the hell would they get these mixed up like this? And that belongs over here, and this belongs over there. Now you can see that factor of safety is calculated at 0.46, which that's not great. So basically this is very similar, just a, you know, more involved way of going through the wizard that we went through before, producing similar results. You know, these areas are exceeding the factor of safety. Okay, this said, you know, we can go like do a hide on this. Get it out of our way, and then we can go factor of safety to look at it. So we'll go back and forth. Between the two. So, but yeah, it's pretty brutal though. Very, very, very close. I mean, one's a terrible factor to go by, this quote-unquote safe zone. At any rate, I'll go ahead and turn these back on. Spectres here. Okay, now we're going to do a report. See the stress throughout the body of the part too, you know, with this. So that's pretty cool. make it easy to get over there, do they? Setting that to zero turned it off. This other plane got apparently reset, but I don't know, it still looks like there's something going through there to me. Anyway, if you click that results advisor, it allows you to animate this with no colors, assuming that's an accurate displacement. I don't know. So these are regions where it's in tension. Guess it's not in compression anywhere. Something, I don't know, maybe it's just stuck on this. same thing. Hit the green check mark. Mistake I seem to make a lot on this. Yeah, because like I said, I'm stuck with these now. Anyway, yeah, if you can show the deformed and non-deformed results. Another, you know, one of these, so.